be hard not to be excited about the potential of taking your own skin cells and turning them into what you might need for Parkinson's disease or diabetes or a spinal cord injury. The gene therapy advances that have happened in the last couple of years for things like immunodeficiencies and this eye disease, Leber's amaurosis, have been breathtaking.
The only way to really know if it's going to work is when you try it in a person, in a human being. To be able to do that, you have to be able to essentially satisfy two principles. The first is you have to be convinced that it might work for that person. And the second is you have to also take on the responsibility to do the least harm to that individual as a result of going through this experimental treatment.
The latest advances in cellular biology and molecular genetics are tested in clinical trials where lives weigh in the balance. And this is intensely dramatic material.
So the boys went first to the hospital so we could take their hematopoietic stem cells from their blood, which is a very simple procedure. And after that, they went back home, so the cells could receive the gene therapy and we could do all the safety assays that are required.
They go to school, they have normal family life and social life. Up to now, I can say that they will be stabilized, hopefully for life, so you can inject him intravenously in the brain, in the eye, or you can take the cells from the patient, for example, hematopoietic cells, put the virus with it, like cooking, all together in a dish, and then you put the cells back to the patient.
Was completely blind, can now see thanks to a gene therapy trial in which he received an injection of healthy genes. This news holds out hope for millions with genetic eye diseases.
Researchers gave 12 patients with the disorder an injection of genetic material to repair the damaged segment.
Before the surgery, could you play any sports?
No, I did, but I would have to have someone like standing right next to me saying, "Here comes the ball," or something like that. And then now, after surgery, I don't need a person just standing there telling me that.
So are you actually on a team?
Yeah, I'm playing Little League right now.
Fantastic. What's your position?
Right, center, and left field.
Wow, that's great.
When I met the team at Children's Hospital Philadelphia, I felt it was like almost being at a family barbecue, because it was very down to earth. You didn't think of them as doctors or what they're doing to change people's lives forever. They seem very dedicated. And it was hard to even think that they were able to change people's genetics, basically, and stop diseases like this. They talk to you as a person that, you know, that you don't know what they're talking about. They don't talk over your head. They explain everything to you and treat you like family. I had a good feeling when they said that they weren't in it for financial gain. That made a big impact with me. And that's why I agreed to talk to media, to help get the support that they need to help Corey and, of course, other children with other diseases, because everything takes money. And we even decided to become organ donors because of this, just to try to help the medical community with their research. So it's changed my life forever, and I appreciate it very much.
that's